was 16 years old, I got my first oil field job. By the time I was 26, I'd been kidnapped, held hostage, got myself in all kinds of trouble. The worst things that could happen in the oil field happened to me then. And very quickly, I learned that the drill floor is a dangerous place to work. It was basically a Roman Polanski movie. It was terrifying. Got home from work and I opened up the mailbox and there's this very official letter with the expensive heavy paper, and I thought, my God, what have I done now? You know, I opened it up and there's this invitation to the Melbourne Writers Festival. I thought, how's a guy like me get invited to the country's premier writing event? I couldn't believe it. So I called them up to make sure there wasn't some other Paul Carter. They said, no, it's you, fantastic, great, wonderful, I'll be there. And then I get the pack and it's got the tickets and it's got the hotel reservations in it and it's got absolutely everything I could possibly need, even maps of Melbourne and where to go and have a latte, you know, it was all there. And then the next day I'm at the airport going to the Melbourne Writers Festival and the guy says, have you got any photo ID? I'm like, oh, and I said, no, I don't, I've just got this piece of paper. And he said, look, I'm really sorry, the APEC summit was on, uh-huh, and all the world leaders were flying into Sydney, and they said, the guy said, I'm sorry, it's bolstered security, you're not getting on this flight without valid photo ID. So I panic and I run out at the airport, jump in a taxi, grab this taxi driver and say, come back to go, and we're off, and I'm on the mobile booking myself on the next flight to Melbourne. And there was one flight left that just maybe would get me into the city in time to get to the Writers Festival. So I get back to the house and the house is on fire. My house is on fire.
That's what I mean.
It's a rental, you know. The taxi driver's looking at me. I'm like, you just leave the engine running, pal. And I run inside the house. And
what, burning house?
Yeah, the house, yeah.
Called the fire brigade.
Luckily for me, the other side of the desk is where we keep the passport. So I put it out. I called the fire department. I called the real estate agent. I don't know if they were just tooling around the neighbourhood on the off chance there'd be a fire, but they were there in like 2 minutes. I'm running out of the house with my passport. The taxi driver's there. And the fire guys and the real estate agent, I'm like, you got keys? Good. And I get in the cab, go, back to the airport. And the guy's standing there, I bang my passport down on the counter, feeling confident that this is going to work out. He picks it up and he goes, yeah, this is expired. Because when the embassy sends you your new passport, they send you back your old one. But they chop the corner off, right? So I'm missing. I'm there going, look, you can see it's me. You look, and he's like, no, it's not a valid ID. I mean, I've caught literally hundreds. No, actually, I would have caught thousands of flights. Commercial airliners, choppers, donkeys, goats, chickens, you know, I've never missed a check-in in
dodgy
my career.
Russian MiGs.
Yeah, you know, and I can't even get out of Perth. It was just, how could I miss this? The thing, it was so important to me. So I thought, well, that's it, I couldn't believe it. I turn around, and there's the airport bookshop. And I thought, photo ID. So I run in, I buy a copy of my book, my first book. I run back up to the guy. And I pull the letter out, and I'm like, it's the Melbourne Writers, and that's me.
You've shown the back page.
Yeah, the cheesy author photo. And I showed it to him, and he went, yeah, okay.
There's a man just screaming out for his own TV show.
Oh,
good to talk to you, Paul.
Paul, lovely to see you again. Thanks for your time.
My pleasure. Yeah. Thank you.